then the chair said, everybody says that, we'll time you. And I said, well, then it might be 20. So I just want to give you a quick talk to make sure myself through a small slide presentation, but I'm conscious I'm standing in front of them, about neighbourhood working. Now, what I think it would be quite helpful to do, we're doing a review currently of how our neighbourhood working model, how effective that is. So I want to talk you through how that review has taken place, what findings we're having at the moment, and maybe what some of the next steps may be. I think why this is important. I think before I want to address that, I'm just going to go back. I think it's really important to talk about what we established here with constituency committees, and why I think it's really important that we do a review. I think it was a number of years ago the constituency committees replaced area forums. And the constituency committees are an opportunity for residents from their constituency to come together and hear updates, as we've just heard from the police, sometimes from fire or health or other key services in their area, and to raise issues that matter and that are local to them. Probably useful, given some of the questions tonight, to let people know that there are four, one from Birkenhead, one for Wallasey, one for Wirral South and one for Wirral West. You can attend your own constituency committee and raise issues that are relevant to you and to your patch there. It sort of gives everyone an opportunity to be able to raise issues that matter to them for their local area. So why is our neighbourhood working strategy important? No one can read this, so I'm essentially going to give you an overview. Various studies show that 97% of residents believe that their local communities could be improved if residents had greater input. And I think that would be a view shared by absolutely everybody in the room, including councillors who are spending their lives trying to knock on doors and deliver leaflets and draw out views from residents. So I think everybody would fully agree with that. Half of the residents of Wirral don't believe that they can influence things in their area at the moment. And I think that's a real shame, and I think it's something we have to change. And I think I know that I'm from the Labour administration. I know that our group of councillors have determined that takes place, and that we do manage to change that. But I'm sure all councillors across Wirral want to see more participation and for residents to have influence in their area. And finally, the Wirral Council is driven by the 2020 vision that was introduced a few years ago, and it has 20 key pledges. And everything we do is designed to achieve those pledges now. And when it's been broken down, because these are some of them quite grand statements, so when those statements are broken down into action points, we've identified that 75% of all of the actions relating to that require better working in our communities. Chair will feel smug to know that it's probably taken me 5 minutes to get through a 10-minute presentation.
Oh, you're doing another 5 minutes.
I will speed up, I really will. I'm going to ask Rachel to help us talk through this bit, but just very quickly, that there was a review. I've asked Rachel to lead a review into how effective the current constituency committees are, and I asked her three specific things, and then Rachel's going to talk us through that. What models out there are there for neighbourhood working? There are different councils across the country that have effective ways of engaging residents. I wanted to know more about them. What value could we place on the investments made in the committees thus far? Obviously, with dwindling budgets, we've got to make sure that every penny we spend on the Wirral is achieving its purpose. And I asked Rachel and the team to do that. And finally, and actually most importantly for me, was what were the views of our partners, our residents, and our councillors, and our communities more broadly. So I'm going to ask Rachel at this point to stand up and talk a little bit about those things.
Working with communities was particularly good, so you can see those success factors were
assessment was determined, the different ways of engaging, so not just one way of talking to local people, different ways of doing that, ownership and transparency. And we also looked at things that made those models not work so well. So there are things like that cultural change amongst both the staff working in local authorities, local residents, views on allocations of funds, and finding different ways in which to engage with local people. And finally, I suppose the summary from that piece of work is there is no kind of answer to this. It's about finding the right way that works for us and utilising the information to determine what's the best way to work for Wirral. Okay, so the second piece of work, as Matthew said, that we undertook was we undertook a review of the social value of return on the investments made through the core budget. So each of the constituency committees, as you probably know, is given a core budget of £50,000 each year to invest in community projects determined by the committee. We looked at the budget for the period since the committees were set up, so to 2013, and for this it goes up to the end of 2017, well, it was at the summer of 2017. And so that totalled across Wirral £566,000, and you can see there's a difference in the scale of projects. So Birkenhead here, we looked at 20 projects, 39 in Wallasey, 19 in Wirral South, and 191 in Wirral West, and that's because there's different models operating, so I think that's an important point to make. If anyone's travelled around to the different committees, you will see that they do all operate slightly differently, and the models for investment money also operate slightly differently. So to give you an example for that, in Wirral West it operates on a small grant scheme, and in Wirral South, for example, they invest on small commissioned projects, so they'll pick a priority and they'll invest a bigger amount of money into it. And what you'll see here is that the investments made reflect the things that people have said are important to them living in those local areas. And the results of that show, for every £1 we spent across Wirral, we got £2.68 back for that money. And obviously there were some recommendations in terms of how we need to make sure we keep monitoring that. Now I thought obviously for you it would be interesting to see what that meant in terms of Birkenhead. So we looked at the 20 projects and there's a bit of a breakdown here. And it shows that there was more spend in Birkenhead on things like anti-social behaviour and clean-up days in Birkenhead. And also it enabled us to have a bit of a bigger look at some of the projects that were done. So for an example project here, so the Neo Cafe, Beechwood Play and Community Centre Hub and North Bedford Development Trust, you see that return on investment increases from £2.68 to £6.21 for every pound spent. So there are some slight differences in terms of the projects, so you get more return back depending on the schemes. And then finally, we did a piece, as Matthew said, talking to lots of people. So there's probably people in this room that were involved in those conversations. Certainly some of our elected members were involved with that, partners from other organisations, so the police, the fire, the NHS. And to try to understand what they think what we do at the moment is working well and where we could improve that. So some of the views that came back was that there was, you know, a real consensus that working with partners and working with communities was absolutely something we had to do and was very, very much valued by lots of people. And particularly, and it's interesting today, we've talked a lot about community action because that was the bit that people cited over and over again as being, you know, really beneficial and feeling like it made a real difference. And that was everybody, that wasn't just residents, that was people working in services. Right across the board, and some of the examples were cited, the Improving Life Chances schemes, some of the door knocks and the litter picks. As you will know, and as we all know, and we're all born and bred as well, and we are a very different place with lots of different communities with different assets. And I think that was a reflection back that actually, you know, one size doesn't fit all actually, and it was something very much about a local response to local needs. And that came out as a very strong message, and also that we use the existing networks that are in communities to engage with rather than expecting everyone to come to us to engage with. So that was quite a strong message, and I think for reflecting that, a particular committee meeting wasn't always felt to be the best way to speak to everybody who wanted to have a view or an opinion. And there were lots of other reasons I could talk about. the small grant and seed funding was really, really valued, and we've heard some of the examples here today about how a little bit of money can just get something going and turn all these little bonfires into a big fire. And across the board, everyone said, you know, it's not about, you know, building big shiny buildings. A small amount of money can really get things off the ground. And similarly, a lot of the community groups that we spoke to in the networks were describing, actually, it's not always money. We really value just asking somebody to help us, you know, unblock a barrier with something. It might be about some advice about how we set up a group and make it legal, how we draw in money from other agencies. So a whole range of advice and support was also really valued. We also got a strong message that the dedicated officer support that we get really helps things make a difference. So Joe's here tonight, and I'm sure you've all probably benefited, well, I know you have, from the hard work that she and the rest of the team do, and we've seen that across in terms of kind of really tackling some of the issues on the ground and also making those connections for people as well. So we heard that message very strongly. And similarly, local residents talked about the real need for having a community builder. So how do we connect a network to other community groups? Because actually that's where some of the real, you know, opportunities are to make things better. And finally, and I think this reflects probably the time that we did this piece of work, which was over the summer, and I'm sure we can all remember Brexit. There was a lot coming back from community residents about feeling of apathy with the political system. So I think it's important to say that. So this kind of sense that there was a bit of tension between how we as public services could connect with local people in a way that was meaningful. So I think that's important to share, but equally a caveat to this as a piece of work. So hopefully that's a very short summary, and probably not at all within the 10 minutes. Okay.
That's because I stood down after five, that's why.
I'm sure you'd like to answer the question.